No, you have to go for this one.
I've been interested in aviation for a very long time. I can like learn and train and actually like gain the information and knowledge in order to be ready for like actual flying.
Now our objective is to just go straight back with the tail.
My brother came along and was like, hey, do you want to build airplanes? And I was like, heck yes. And so we got we joined in with the airplane restoration project, and I'm now just got an internship with the airport. I'm working towards a aviation certificate with the school, and I'm loving it.
Now we're gonna check the tires, that they're the proper inflation.
Oh, is this flight school?
Because we'll do a full walk around and we'll end it at that tire.
No, okay. It's high school.
Let's bring it over here.
John Green is getting his wings at River Springs Charter School in Riverside. And Mia Kayumjian is practicing her skills at Canyon High School, 35 miles away in Anaheim. They're among only a handful of high schools in California offering aviation as an elective course, two different flight paths to possible careers. John's program takes place near Flaybob Airport, one of the oldest surviving airports in California.
Is that why you still face your ridge?
I think that's good. Right there.
Mia's aspirations are taking flight thanks to the determination of teacher and pilot Steve Smith.
I felt like a lot of our students were just taking it because it sounded like a fun elective without really knowing the potential behind it.
His program started as a one-year class. Students learned how planes fly and the fundamentals of operating them. Then he added a second year. Aviation 2, a true ground school for pilots in training.
Right there, John Wayne.
John Wayne, there we go.
I started to see a higher level of students that are looking to do something with aviation, and they're taking the class because it's appealing to them as a potential career, not just a fun elective.
A lot of my weekends do get taken up, but the thing is, I love doing it. It's not necessary, it doesn't even feel like education because we're out there, we're on the flight lines.
I would definitely love to be able to have this as a career.
We believe it's not just good enough to give our students a high school diploma. We want our children to be empowered. We want them to hit the ground running when they graduate from high school, really knowing what their interests are, what their aptitudes are, and what they might want to do for a career.
For both schools, aviation is part of the so-called STEM initiative, a national drive to refocus public education on science, technology, engineering, and math. California has pumped $1.5 billion into public schools offering career technical education, or CTE, programs such as these.
It's just an exciting thing because you see kids getting a lot more engaged, a lot more excited about learning, and we know they're learning those core skills that are going to take them into the workplace and actually maybe get them a job.
I'm thinking we do a right pattern this time.
In addition to those workplace skills, students are learning the academic basics.
We cover science. We definitely incorporate technology. We discuss a little bit on the engineering side with physics and everything else and the design. And then, of course, math. We use math for calculating performance data and weight and balance and everything else.
It just kind of connects all the subjects, and I think it's a really good thing. Even history, I mean, we learned about World War II and with the aviation side of it, and World War I when Air Force just began.
Before even the Air Force began, a couple of aviation students named Orville and Wilbur Wright made history with a plane like this one. Over at Flaybob Airport, a replica plane is part of an internship program for River Springs students interested in technical careers.
There's so much you can do if you know how to use your hands and a few tools. And it's really, I think it's a part of learning how to use your brain, because it's what your brain is using, you know, and you have to teach it somehow. And you don't teach it by tap, tap, tapping on the board all the time.
There's also a financial benefit for students training at their public school when compared to the cost of private training.
Typically, you're looking anywhere from about $8,000 to potentially $14,000. Just to get that private pilot's license. With the simulators, they're getting real flight lessons, just in small pieces. So I'm teaching them the maneuvers and the procedures that they would learn, that they would perform in an actual airplane, and they get to practice it here for free.
The simulators and computers and 3D printer are among the purchases Canyon High School made with CTE grant money. The engineless airplane parked in the school's former auto shop was free, a donation from an industry contact.
Some of these students don't necessarily enjoy the classroom portion. They want to get their hands dirty and they want to work with their hands, and we don't have many opportunities for them to do that anymore.
So the flaps in this airplane, it almost looks like a parking brake.
I get to go around the airplane and say, okay, well, what is this? What does it do? And they're taking what they saw on paper or on a screen, and now they're seeing it in real life, and they get to touch it, and they get to move the aileron and see how it works.
While students dismantle instruments and get real airplanes oiled up and checked out at River Springs and Flabob, both schools stop just shy of officially getting them off the ground. There are insurance barriers and the significant costs of fuel and maintenance. So although these planes don't actually take off, certain students can taxi them around the runway, all part of the hands-on approach.
I tell my teachers, I don't want you to be a teacher. I want you to be a facilitator of learning. I want you to provide the resources, provide the challenges to the students, and guide them through self-discovery to learn the content.
But still, why aviation? In Southern California, long a hotbed of aviation and aerospace, an urgent need is looming.
The pilot shortage is coming, and it's a real concern for the airlines especially. Pilots have a mandatory retirement age of 65 that's set by the FAA, and so the concern is that we are not going to have enough pilots to fill the jobs that are about to be available.
Throughout the next few years, there's going to be less pilots, and so I think starting at this young of age and just being able to get that head start is something that most people don't get.
All of us were just really lucky to be able to be brought up in the program at our age.
Over in Riverside, River Springs Charter School eagerly anticipates building new aviation classrooms right next to the runway at Flabob Airport. While at Canyon, Steve Smith hopes to build aviation up to a four-year program, perhaps even offering training in drone operations.
I feel like a program like this, it's just going to give them another reason to do their best in school, in their other classes. If they decide, yeah, I want to be a pilot, well then your education matters, and you have something that you're working toward. It's not just, I just need to graduate high school.
Experts estimate there will be a need for 600,000 new pilots globally by the year 2035. While much of that demand is in the Asia-Pacific region, nearly 20% of those new aviation jobs will be right here in North America. Airlines are taking notice, and Emirates Airline has responded by building a new flight school in Dubai that can train 600 pilots at a time.